Okay students, now we are going to, in this lecture of ionic equilibrium, we are in the chapter of ionic equilibrium. Okay, so in ionic equilibrium, one of the difficult topic and most important topic is buffer solutions. Okay, what is the topic we are going to cover today? Buffer solutions. Okay. So buffer solutions means the solutions which have constant pH. Okay, solutions which have constant pH. Okay, constant pH, whose pH will not change, or the otherwise we can say solutions which resist change. Resist constant pH means resist. Okay, resist change. They don't want to change. The solutions which resist change in pH. Okay, on addition of small amount of acid or base or water. Okay, so the any solutions which resist change in pH, their pH is remains constant. Okay, by change in addition of small amount to certain extent only it will work. That what, up to what certain extent it can work is measured by the buffer capacity, that we are going to do it afterwards. Okay, so solution whose pH does not change much on addition of small amount of acid, small amount of base or water, then it is called as a what? Buffer solution. Okay, buffer solutions are very much have different applications. Okay, especially in biological systems, in our human body, if we want body temperature or body pH is to be maintained constant, then carbonic acid and carbon dioxide, H2CO3 and HCO3- will act as a buffer. Okay, so they are the application part, but that part we are not going to do in the chemistry, that you will come to know in the biology if required. Okay, so quantitative part and explanatory with the chemical equations we are going to study here. Understood? So buffer system means, is it understood? The system or the solution or a mixture which can resist the change in pH on small addition of acid or base or water. Okay, such solutions are called as a buffer solutions. Understood? So what are the characteristics of buffer? What are the characteristics of buffer and how it differs? How it differs from the normal solution? Okay, let us take normal solution. Okay, normal solution, and let us take buffer solution. Okay, these are the two comparative thing we are going to do it now. Understood? So if we add small amount of, okay, normally we can add small amount of acid we can add, small amount of base we can add, or water we can add. Understood? So these are the normal solution how it react, and buffer solution how it reacts I am going to explain. Okay, so if I am talking about the pH, we are talking about what? pH. Understood? In normal solution, if you add acid to the any solution, irrespective of acid, base or any solution, normally pH will, if you add acid, pH will what happens? Decreases. Okay, so pH, buffer what I told you? Constant. Understood? Now pH, small amount of base, then pH will increase. So if I am talking about pH decreases, obviously you should understand pOH will increase, because pH plus pOH is equal to how much? 14. So here pH will increase and pOH will decrease. Okay, so if we are adding water, concentration what happens? If it is acid, concentration of acid will decrease. let us take 10 to the power of minus 2 molarity. Okay, I am adding by concentration it is decreased to 10 to the power of minus 3. Then pH will what happen? pH will increase. See, earlier concentration was 10 to the power of minus 2 molarity. Okay, then now that time pH was 2. Now it is diluted to 10 times. Therefore, concentration becomes 10 to the power of minus 3. Therefore, pH will increase. Understood? So, in all these cases, pH will remain constant. Okay, that is the difference between the normal solution and buffer solution. Is it clear? We, along with the buffer solution, you can also understand now what is the change in pH for the normal solution. Okay, note down this, then I will tell you about the characteristics of buffer solution, then we will go for the types of buffer, then we will go for the buffer capacity. So try to watch it till last and immediately like this session, like this class, like this video section, so that I can be improve myself with your motivation. Okay, and if it is possible, if you are in the 11th class, if you are in the first year, try to maintain continuity daily. Almost all lectures are uploaded as of now. So maintain proper attendance immediately after the video upload and maintain proper notes along with the numerical session. You should practice the questions from any topic. We almost have in the physical different numerical session. Okay. So that practicing of that questions also very important, and maintain notebook, proper notebook, and I am sure that you will crack any exam you are attempting. Okay, it is applicable for both NEET, IIT, mains, advanced, AIIMS, AFMC, JIPMER, BITSAT, etc. All examination syllabus is nicely covered with each and every topical video lecture. Okay. So, note down this, then we will go for the further topic. Okay, now these are same things only explained in the points wise. First of all, they should have constant pH. Second thing, on long standing, if you are keeping it stored for a longer time, that time also pH should not change. And pH should not change on dilution or addition of water. And pH should not change on addition of small amount of acid or base. These are the four characteristics of the buffer solution. Okay? Note down. Noted. So if not noted, pause it and you can note down. Understood? Now we are going to study about the buffer, types of buffer. Okay? Next topic is what? Types of buffer. What is the next topic? Types of buffer. Okay, buffer solutions are divided into two types. Okay, first one is called as simple buffer. What is the first one? Simple buffer. Next one, it is called as a mixed buffer. Okay, simple buffer is a single compound. Mixed buffer is a mixture of two compounds. Okay, two compounds will be mixed together to get the mixed buffer. Only one molecule, one type of compound is available, then it is called as a simple buffer. Okay, these are only one type, these are further divided into two types. What are those two types? I am going to cover it separately with proper explanation how they are formed and what is the formula derivation. Normally, you cannot understand the formula derivation, but nowadays the questions are in the formula derivation step wise also they are asking. So, derivation of that formula also very, very important. Okay. So, have you noted this? And I will explain what is the buffer action. Why buffer action? Okay. So, first let us see about the simple buffer. First, what we will see? Simple buffer. Is it visible if I write over here? Simple buffer. Okay. Simple buffer is a salt of, it is one compound. It is a salt solution. It is a salt solution of weak acid. Weak acid. and weak base. Okay, weak acid and weak base. So what is the weak salt of weak acid and weak base? Let us take weak acid as HCN. Okay, HCN will hydrolyze. Okay, will hydrolyze to form H positive plus CN minus. Understood? Now NH4OH. So this is going to give you NH4 positive plus OH negative. Okay, then this salt formed by NH4CN. Okay, NH4CN is a salt of weak acid and weak base. Okay, it can undergo hydrolysis. It can undergo hydrolysis to form NH4OH plus HCN. Understood? So, but it is also weak in this direction, very less, in this direction, very less. So, pH formula also I told you, 1 by 2 into just previous topic. You can go through that salt hydrolysis, how this came and what are the factors affecting that, I clearly explained. So, okay. So, PKW, understood, ionic product of water, which is 14, plus PKA, minus PKB, okay. See, we have any choice? No, this is constant for an acid, this is constant for an acid, and it is always constant of 14. So, we cannot change the pH by any change. Any concentration of acid term is there? No, if we add acid, is there any factor going to change? Ka does not depend on the concentration, Kb does not depend on the concentration, Kw does not depend on the concentration. So, by varying concentration of acid, base or water, then we cannot change the pH. Okay, that's why this constant, its pH is constant. Okay, so that's why it acts as a buffer. Why it acts as a buffer and how to find out the pH of that buffer, is it understood? So, note down, simple buffer, it is a salt solution of weak acid and weak base. Salt must be made from the weak acid and weak base. This is the solution. Okay. So, this solution will act as a buffer because of the concentration term is not available in the pH formula. Okay. Note down. Okay, noted. Now we will start about the mixed buffer. Okay, in the mixed buffer, it is about the first acidic buffer. There are two types of buffer. First one is called as a acidic buffer, okay, and second one is called as a basic buffer. Second one is called as what? Basic buffer, okay. So first we will study about the acidic buffer. So as the term is used, mixed, okay, it is a mixture of, acidic buffer is a mixture of weak acid, plus salt, okay. But that salt must be salt of weak acid. And strong base. Because a salt is made up of how many things? Two things. So for that preparation, okay, salt of strong weak acid and strong base. Okay, what is that? Let us take CH3COOH is the acid I have selected. I have to make the salt from this only, okay, but what I will use, the strong base. So this salt, it is forming CH3COONA, okay, this is a salt of weak acid and strong base. So this product and one of the reactant, okay, this is called as a, this total, it is mixture, is called as a acidic buffer. Acidic buffer is how many things? It is a mixture of weak acid and salt of the weak acid with strong base. Salt of weak acid with the strong base. Is it understood? So this is how it is formed. And it, one more example is boric acid and sodium borate. Okay. Another example is boric acid. Note down this, I will tell you that also. Okay, this is another example of the boric acid and sodium borate. This is also acidic buffer. Okay. Now we will derive the formula and understand what is buffer capacity or buffer action. Okay. So let us take simple example, weak acid. Okay. So weak acid will be CH3COOH. Understood? And it is a weak acid, so I will keep it as a single direction, CH3COO minus plus H plus. Okay. And it is also having salt. So salt will be mostly completely ionized. So CH3COO minus plus Na plus. Understood? So for this acid, okay, for this acid what we have? pKa. Okay, first let us understand Ka. What is the Ka? Ka of a weak acid is equal to concentration of CH3COO minus into concentration of H plus into concentration of CH3COOH. Is it understood? So here I want to find out the pH of this entire solution. For that I require H plus. Concentration of H plus is equal to Ka into concentration of CH3COOH divided by concentration of CH3COO negative. Is it understood? Cross multiplied, that's all. Simple what I have done, cross multiplied. But what I wanted now, pH. So pH means negative log, okay. So negative log, if I apply this side, it is going to be pH. So negative log of Ka into CH3COOH divided by CH3COO minus. Okay. So this negative log of Ka, we can write it as a pKa. Okay. Minus log of CH3COOH, for general purpose I will write it as an acid. Concentration of acid. See here, there are two persons giving the CH3COO minus. But it is a weak acid, it is completely soluble salt. So, this is, if it is giving 10, it will give 0.001 only. So, the net concentration will be 10 plus 0.001. So, indirectly we can take this concentration as a concentration of salt only. This is what we call it as a common ion effect in weak acids. Okay. Here common ion is what? Acetate ion. The most of the acetate ion produced from the salt, very negligible quantity of the acetate produced from the weak acid. So directly, instead of making the clumsy situation, I am writing this part as a concentration of salt. Okay? So concentration of salt. Is it understood? So acid upon salt. Okay? So this is what the formula is. Note down. Note down properly, each and every step must be understood clearly. Okay, noted. Okay, so to keep this positive, we can also write pH is equal to pKa. To keep this positive, we can write log. Numerator, it is going to be salt. And the denominator, it is going to be acid. Okay. So this is the final formula, we get it. Understood? So this is called as a Henderson equation. Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. Okay. Henderson equation is sufficient. Henderson equation is used to find out the pH of a buffer. Okay. So here we can, from this formula, we can conclude two things. pH increases with increase in concentration of salt. Okay, see, concentration of salt increased, then it is directly proportional. Here also plus sign. But one thing you should remember, if it is increased by 10 times, there will be increase by 1. Because log you are applying, log 100, then 2. So pH will increase by 2. Okay. So in that directly, if it is making 10, that pH will not be increased by 10. Okay. So pH will increase with increase in concentration of salt. Is it understood? Same way, pH will decrease with increase in concentration of acid, because it is in the denominator, both are inverse proportional. Okay, denominator increase, total value will decrease. Okay, otherwise we can take it as a minus also. So this will decrease the pH value. Okay, note down this. And sometimes in the numerical shortcut method I will tell you. So after noting down this shortcut, directly you can write. Okay. So this formula you need not to use if you are given with normality into volume. Direct shortcut. Shortcut is that pH is equal to pKa plus log of NS. S means salt. Okay. NSVS divided by NA into VA. Understood? Actually we are talking about the what? Concentration. But here we are getting the equivalent moles, because all are there in the same solution. So volume will be common. Suppose if I am adding 200 ml of salt solution with 300 ml. But here we will divide it by 500, here also divided by 500 to get the concentration. So they will get cancelled. So don't worry about this formula. If normality volume is given, directly put into this formula, you will get this. Only thing, you should convert them into the normality, molarity and normality. How to convert, already you know that. Okay, so this is a shortcut formula for the buffer solution, acidic buffer. I think now it is clearly understood where from this formula came, why this is the only formula, how the buffer action, how it is able to resist the change in pH. Resist the change in pH is because of the weak acid. If we add acid, then as it is a weak acid, it will not go much in the forward direction. If you add base also, base will be absorbed by the salt. Okay, so salt is not going to change the pH by going in the backward direction. That's why there is no much change in the pH. That is what called as a buffer action. This is what it is signified in the formula also. Okay, note on this. Okay, noted. Now we are going to study about the basic buffer. Basic buffer is very important because we have made in-depth study of the acidic buffer. If you study one part very in-depth, that is immediately you will get the advantage that you can easily understand the second part. Okay, so basic buffer. So what is basic buffer? It is also mixture. It is a mixture. Very good. So mixture of what else? Weak base. There it was weak acid, now it is weak base. Plus what is that? Salt. Okay, salt of the same weak base. Salt of the same weak base, but this time we should use the strong acid. There we use the strong base. Now here we are going to use the strong acid. It is a mixture of weak base plus salt of weak base with the strong acid. Okay, so I will take an example. Weak base, I will take NH4OH. Okay, so NH4OH will give you the NH4 plus OH minus. Understood? And I have to use this acid to convert into NH4OH plus, let us take sulfuric acid, H2SO4. So this time we have to take 2 moles. Then we will get NH4 whole twice SO4 plus 2H2O. Okay, so this salt and this, it is a weak base. This is a weak base and it is a salt of the this part. Okay, so weak buffer formula is NH4OH along with NH4 whole twice SO4. So this combination is called as a basic buffer. This combination is called as basic buffer. Okay, note down this. Okay, noted. For this formula, what will be the formula? Same, pH is equal to, you can try and I will write. Okay, for basic buffer, what we will write? For basic buffer, ultimately we will write POH only. Okay, and there it was pKa, here it is going to be pKb plus log of salt upon base. Salt upon acid it was there, it is salt upon base. Okay. Sometimes for basic buffer also, if we have to find out pH, then what you will do? 14 minus POH, you will get the pH of basic buffer also. It is not that basic buffer is not having POH, pH and everything, it will be there. Basic buffer also have pH and acidic buffer also have POH. Only thing, it should be subtracted from the 14 to get the required value. Okay, so you can derive the formula like this also. See, NH4OH reversible, then NH4 positive plus OH minus, this for this it is the Kb value. Okay, then NH4Cl, let us take easiness, NH4Cl, NH4 positive plus Cl minus. So there it was acetate ion, here it is ammonium ion is the common ion. Okay, in this place we will write the concentration of base, sorry, salt. Okay, in this place, ammonia place, and from this we will get the POH formula. POH is equal to, by cross multiplying as we did in the acidic buffer, you can do it. And once you know the procedure, you can immediately apply on the similar things. I hope you are that much smart enough. Okay. If you are not like that video, at least kindly like it now and watch till the last for the buffer capacity. Very important topic. Okay, don't lose your patience. Write notes continuously. Okay, basic buffer example along with the formula. Same formula you can shortcut also you can use. What is that shortcut? NS upon NS into VS divided by NB into VB here. Okay, so that three part equation you can write down or not, pH and POH, how it will increase and decrease. Okay, so let us start with the buffer capacity. Okay, buffer capacity, understood? So what is buffer capacity, how it is defined, I am going to tell you. Okay, buffer capacity is denoted with Fa. Okay, it is a measure of, it is a measure of resistive nature. Okay, resistive nature of change in pH of buffer solution. Okay, buffer solution. So how much, till how much addition of acid, till how much addition of base, it can resist the change in pH, that capacity. Somebody will start changing immediately after few drops of acid. Some solution will not change the pH even after large amount of acid also. So that resistive power to change in pH is measured with the help of the buffer capacity. Okay, so buffer capacity higher, if you are calculating buffer capacity, if higher the buffer capacity, better is buffer. Okay, so we should select a buffer whose buffer capacity is very higher. That means it can keep its pH constant even after large amount of acid or large amount of base. That is the best quality of the buffer. Okay, so but in normal, how to find out numericals and what are the best range, I will tell you. Okay, So buffer capacity formula is equal to number of moles of acid or base added. How many moles of acid or base added, and it resulted in how much is the change in pH? Okay, change in pH is how much? Okay, after adding three moles, change in pH is suppose 0.1. So change in pH is 0.1, moles is 3. So 3 by 0.1, like that you can calculate the buffer capacity. Okay. So best buffer capacity range. Buffer capacity range. Okay. Is found best. Okay. Is found best in terms of pH. So first one is pH. Okay. So pH, where it can work as a good buffer, is pKa plus or minus 1. Okay. Suppose pKa is equal to 5. That is 10 to the power of minus 5 is Ka, then pKa will be 5. So it can work as a good buffer in the range of 6 to 4. Okay. So first one is in terms of pH. Second one is in terms of the concentration. So 0.1 to with respect to pH with respect to 1. Okay. 10 times the concentration. Okay. Present concentration, it is multiplied by 10 divided by 10. Plus or minus 1. Plus by 10 means log 10. And minus 1 means 1 upon 10. That is 0.1. In terms of the concentration is 0.1 and 10. Okay, note down the second formula. In terms of concentration, it is 0.1 less than salt upon concentration of acid / base. If it is acidic buffer, it will be acid. If it is basic buffer, you will take base by 10. Okay, so acidic buffer, you will take only, it is not acid divided by base, either acid or base. For base, you will substitute base concentration. For acidic buffer, you will substitute acid concentration. Okay. So that ratio must be between the 0.1 to 10. When it decreases below 0.1, buffer capacity is not maximum. When it increases above 10, then also buffer capacity is not maximum. Okay. Buffer capacity is maximum when the available pH lies between plus or minus 1 of pKa, or concentration of the given solution lies between 0.1 to 10 of the salt upon acid or salt upon base ratio. Okay. So this is about the buffer capacity. Now almost all every concept is crystal clear to you, but it will be clarified only if you go through the question session. Let's meet in the question session. See you. Bye bye.